Today's clock is a banjo clock made in the United States of America by the Sessions Clock Company. It's the second banjo clock I've had. The first one was in New Haven, which had Westminster chimes. Unfortunately, the case was incomplete, and I actually made a new section corresponding to this section on it, but the decal on the glass didn't work out quite right, and eventually I got fed up with it and I sold the clock, which I regret, of course. It's one of these things I do that I regret later, but I have this one now. Although this one doesn't have Westminster chimes, it's still very much a worthy successor. It opens at the bottom here, and there we have, I think that is an Ansonia pendulum, I'm not sure. It certainly doesn't seem to belong to this clock, and it has an extra little bit of wire to adapt it to the end of the pendulum rod, just to make sure it's long enough to keep time. And there you see the two steel rods for the striking. I particularly like the artwork on this clock. The eagle on top is slightly loose, but that can be sorted. And now let's hear it. And as you've probably gathered by the fact that this video is being shot upstairs, there's no more room for big clocks to hang in the living room. So I think most big wall clocks I obtain from now on will be going somewhere here, in this small remaining space between the banjo clock and the top of the stairs. Which means I really must get this clock back in action. There's a wire loose so the top note of the chimes doesn't sound, and that's the only reason I stopped the clock. So as more and more clocks fill up this space, I'll really need to get this one back in action. And here is the movement of the Sessions banjo clock. Cartwheel striking, and if you can see it up there, an inside escapement. And down there, if you can see it, it says Sessions Clock Company, Forestville, Connecticut. Just a very ordinary American clock movement. And looking down into the hollow case, there is the gong block and the two hammers. The gong block is fixed to the back of the case from the inside with three screws. Okay, look at the interaction between the crutch and the pendulum. The escapement is right at the top, but the pendulum is suspended just below the centre arbor. Another worthy addition to my collection. Yeah, I'll get this one fixed too sometime. Don't know when. Okay, if you liked this video, please click like and subscribe. My Facebook link is down below. And I'll see you in the next video.